What's going on, friends? Logan Myerz here for Cinephellas.com doing more 31 Days of Horror. Tonight I'm going to be talking about the film that came out in 1982, Friday the 13th, Part 3, in 3D. It was a big deal back then, movies being put out in 3D. My parents actually took my uncle to see this in the theater when it came out that year. They told him they're going to see like a comedy or a drama or something, but they took him to see Friday the 13th Part 3, and he hates horror movies. They scare the shit out of him. And I guess my uncle got up during the movie and like yelled at the movie screen and was like, "Kill that son of a bitch!" He was like all into it and terrified at the same time. And all these years later, he laughs about it. He still hates horror movies. I don't think he's ever seen another horror movie in the theater since then, since 1982. But I thought that was really funny. So this time around, we have Steve Miner returning to direct Part 3. He directed Part 2, which is a really fantastic entry in the franchise. But this time around, we have a group of teenagers or college kids, they don't really say. They're heading out to Higgins Haven, which is this like getaway. The main character in the film, Chris Higgins, it's her family's cabin, essentially. So they're going out there, you know, to get stoned and bang and get killed by Jason Voorhees. But this time around, one of the interesting characters in Part 3 is Shelley, played by Larry Zerner. He's the one that pretty much introduces the hockey mask. This is how Jason Voorhees gets the iconic hockey mask in this film. And Shelley's a really great character. I really wish they would have done more with this character in this film, but he was pretty interesting. He's like a, you know, a younger kid. He wants to be an actor. He uses like effects and blood and gore and stuff to scare off his friends at the cabin. He has like a wetsuit on and like the hockey mask, and Jason eventually gets it. We have all pretty much the run-of-the-mill characters this time around. Chris is the main, you know, protagonist. She's the final girl and not as good as Amy Steele in Part 2. She's pretty much kind of boring throughout the film. But this movie is shot in 3D, so there's a lot of ridiculous over-the-top 3D scenes in the movie, like a guy moving a broom and like goes through the screen and like jumps out of you, and there's like a snake that's in a cage that jumps out of you in 3D, but you can tell it's on a string. It's really poorly done and comedic to, you know, watch that scene. Obviously other kills and stuff with Jason Voorhees in 3D, but that was the whole point of this film. It was definitely felt a lot different compared to Part 2. I thought Part 2 was definitely a lot more solid all around, but I do really enjoy Part 3 in 3D. You know, it's a classic, and it's definitely one of my favorite films in the entire franchise. So this time around, we have Richard Brooker playing Jason Voorhees. Definitely one of my favorite Jasons as well, just the way he looked. He was like a big dude, and he was all like kind of deformed. He had like the shaved head compared to Part 2, where he had the longer hair. But with him putting on the iconic mask, I mean, he really sells this character. And also at the same time, he doesn't really give a fuck. He doesn't really just kill camp counselors. He goes after anybody that gets in his way. There's some silly scenes where biker gang shows up that are going after Shelley and this girl, Vera. But it doesn't end well for the biker, so it's anybody that gets in Jason's way. And a majority of the movie takes place in the barn at Higgins Haven, and I really like that atmosphere. I'm not really sure why Jason just, like, hung out in there for the majority of the movie, but, you know, one by one, the characters going into this barn to check it out and look around, including the biker gang. You know, Jason's in there lurking and waiting for them to make the fatal mistake. But in the film, we find out Chris's backstory and her family's cabin, Higgins Haven. Essentially, she had a fight with her family. She goes off into the woods, and that's when she has the encounter with, they don't say, Jason Voorhees, even though he looks completely different in this flashback scene. Leading up until the end of the film, we have the battle of, you know, Jason going after Chris, trying to kill her. Pretty much a lot of anticlimactic sequences. It's not really that intense or interesting. It's kind of copy and pasted from the other films. Chris is really not that interesting of a character, honestly, and I just couldn't really get into this role, and I didn't really care what happens to her. But Richard Brooker playing Jason Voorhees, really fantastic, especially at the end. There's a scene at the very end of the film in the barn where Jason falls out of the barn and gets hung by a rope, but still alive, and he like lifts up his mask and you see what he looks like, and it's really fantastic. I love the makeup work, the way he looks. Somehow he still survives, even being hit in the head with an axe. It really sets up one of the silliest endings in the entire franchise, with Chris escaping Jason Voorhees and falling asleep in a canoe on the water for some odd reason. Why would you do that after, you know, fighting off a killer throughout the night? I would definitely hightail it out of there and get as far away as possible. But she goes on the water right by the barn and falls asleep and wakes up, and it's a zombified Mrs. Voorhees that comes out of the water for some odd reason, and the makeup work looked really silly on that. But she basically grabs Chris, and that's the end of the film. So definitely not one of the best endings in the franchise. It's more comedic to rewatch these and go back and like, why did they make that decision? But overall, I had a really good time with Friday the 13th Part 3 in 3D. Definitely one of my favorite films in the franchise. There's a lot of silliness that was really great in the 80s. The use of 3D technology, the snake and the popcorn and the killing scenes were, you know, pretty fun to watch and also terrible because you can see the strings, like they move the snake and everything. It looked pretty half-assed. If you look past that, you can have a good time with it. The characters in this movie aren't as interesting, but there was also the setup of Jason Voorhees getting the iconic hockey mask and also, you know, introducing Shelley and the lackluster final girl, Chris. I think Steve Miner did a pretty good job, not as good as part two with this film. There's a lot of issues with it. Using the 3D technology kind of took away from the whole like characters and character development. They're just all kind of there doing stupid things throughout the movie just to use the 3D technology. I think if they wrote the characters a little better, more importantly, Shelley, I would have liked to see him last longer in the franchise. I think this movie would have been a lot better, but overall had a pretty good time with it. Great time to revisit Friday the 13th Part 3 in 3D during the Halloween season. So if you guys haven't seen this film, I highly recommend it. Definitely check it out and make sure to put on your 3D glasses. I'm giving Friday the 13th Part 3 in 3D a 3.5 out of 5 Jason Voorhees hair pieces. So what did you guys think of Part 3 in 3D? What did you like about it? What didn't you like about it? What did you guys think of that ending? Let us know in the comments below and don't forget to hit subscribe. This is Logan Myerz signing out from Higgins Haven until the next movie review for 31 Days of Horror. Cheers!